I know you're probably wondering what happened on Evernote in July. Here's the answer. Let's start from mobile. There are four main things on mobile. Let's go through them. So the first one is tasks. When you're in the task section and you apply some filters, like in this case, for instance, and then you navigate to notes, because maybe you want to see your note list, and you go back to tasks, your filters disappear generally. Well, this is not happening anymore. With the new update, we've made it so that when you go back to tasks, you still have your filters there until you clear them with the handy little button that there's there, or for instance, if you kill the app and open it a few days later. Second one, there are some tweaks to the account menu. There's a new arrow close to the name that lets you access more account settings. And there's the last option, the logout option that's new. Previously, you had to go in the account settings and select logout. Now it's there, it's just handy. Third, when you scroll the note list for a while, then instead of having to scroll all the way back to the top manually, you can just click notes again in the navbar and it will automatically bring you to the top again, like this. And then we've improved the note headers, so the section before the note title. First, you can you have a new shortcut for adding tags quickly. And then there's another row that we added in case your note contains a reminder, tasks, or a backlink. You will see that metadata right above the title. Let's also take a look at desktop. So breadcrumbs. Breadcrumbs are the little indicators at the top of your note that tell you where that note is. Generally, you will see the notebook that that note is in, but you can also see spaces, for instance. You couldn't previously see if the note was in the shared with me section, if it belonged there. Now with the new update, we've just made it more consistent. And if that note you're looking at is contained in the shared with me section, is a note that somebody shared with you, you will see the shared with me breadcrumb there. And then updates to AI Edit. This is a big one. You've been asking for it for a long time. Basically, let's say you have a note that you've been working on for many days. It's a long note. You previously couldn't use AI Edit with that. We had a limitation of context. Basically, we have character limits when processing long notes, but now we fixed it and you will be able to use AI Edit on very long notes. And third, if you remember some time ago, we created this new arrow button here that lets you hide or show the note list, but it wasn't super clear in the first iteration how to go back to the note list. It's just here, you just need to click the button again. But some people were finding it confusing. So basically now we've made it so that when you click on notes here, the note list always appears. Just a little tweak for better UX. And regarding the same topic, fourth improvement, we've also tweaked the shortcut. So the previous shortcut was CMD Alt V or Control Alt V on Windows. It was a bit hard to remember. A much easier one to remember is CMD Alt left and right arrows. And last on desktop, search. So as you know, in the last few months, we've worked a lot on search. The feedback we've got on the new search experience is great. We're very happy to see that people are liking it, especially the new performance. The new tweaks are four. So first one, if you search for, let's say Evernote, like in this case, and you press enter, you will see a list of results. Now, let's say that the results are a bit too many. You want to filter even more. You want to be more precise. Now, when opening the search bar again, you will have that keyword, and it's going to be pre-selected so that you can start writing immediately. The second thing is show search result in trash. So super simple. You will see an icon trash close to the note that is in trash. Previously, we didn't show the notes that were contained inside trash. There's a new clearer empty state when no results are found. You will see it right from the model. You will not need to press enter to see that there are no notes matching that search. And fourth, when searching from a notebook, so let's say you are inside a notebook, you're in the notebook view and you press search, by default it used to only search inside that notebook. We've asked for a lot of feedback, and it's clear that people prefer it to default to everywhere. So it's gonna search everywhere and you will still have your notebook here. So if you want to filter only search results in that notebook, it's going to be super easy. You will just need to click that to apply the filter. And there are also some new AI web tools. There are two. The first one is a new AI diagram web tool. It will help you create flowcharts or other types of diagrams starting from text. So you can just type and describe what diagram you want, and you can just generate new diagrams. Pretty cool. You will have a link in the description of the video. And then the second one is an AI detector. As more and more pieces of content are built using AI, we want to help you basically make sure that the content that you write still sounds human. So you can navigate to evernote.com/AI-detector and you will be able to paste your note or content in the tool, and we will calculate the probability that the text was created or generated using the help of AI. Thank you so much. I will see you next month, and don't forget to add to the comments below every piece of feedback that you might have, any candidates for new improvements that we might work on in the next few months. We always read the comments. We can't reply to all of them, but we always read the comments. So make sure that you give us your best suggestions. Thank you very much.